So yeah,
we're about to see who knows each other better. Do she know me better or do I know her better? I think she gonna win this one.
I don't know me better.
What the?
I don't even know me. Gosh.
Before y'all get into this video though, make sure
you subscribe, like, and comment.
Y'all know if y'all go to her channel, she do the thing with her face, with her hands and stuff. So.
But anyways, make sure you subscribe. And when you watch the video all the way through, like and come say hey.
So. Yeah, I better say hey.
They don't ever say hey. They want to fight.
I want to fight. When it comes to men, what's your type?
Whoa.
So do you know my type?
Well,
from observation, you like dark skin. You like tall. You like, yo, shag them little babies. They got a simulac on it, bro.
No,
not for them. You like dark skin, tall, athletic built, like in a way. You know, they can get away with some features, but mainly athletic built. In a way,
a gentleman with a little thug. She like to feel safe.
Make me feel so safe.
Turns me on. And that's pretty much all I can think of.
Well, she is correct, guys. I do love dark skins. They turn me on. And I love. Maybe taller. And I do love a gentleman, but I love a thug too. I'm trying to stay away from these gangbangers. Let me stop playing. I'm just playing. Well, my observation, I think she likes short men. Blacker than black men.
I like my man Blurple, baby.
A gentleman. I don't think she liked thugs. I've never seen her. Yeah, no. The observation I get, not a thug. And I believe she loves to have them. Like, they have to have their stuff together. Like, when I say together, I mean together. That her type is, if you don't got your stuff together, bye-bye. So, yeah. It's all right.
Everything was right except the short, you know? Because I'm short myself, so I got to be able to look up to you. Because, you know, when we get married, you got to be able to pick me up.
Bless you. Do we have tattoos?
Do we?
And how many? She has one. One tattoo, guys. She has one tattoo.
And where is it?
One of these shoulders. One of these shoulders. That's what the tattoo is. So, I know I got that right.
I do have a tattoo. And it's on this shoulder.
I told y'all.
And what is it?
A lion.
And you got words?
No, but it got something else on there. You about to jab me, you about to choke me. Why you got that so tight?
She cheating, y'all. I see that.
A heart and a crown.
Nice play.
Well, she has a lion with a heart and a crown. It's really nice.
I'ma just be honest. I know she got that. But I just discovered that she just had got a whole new one. So I don't know how many she got. She got a lot.
Yeah. I had my whole leg done. Front and back side. And then I got a new one right here, which don't look pretty good, so I'm not showing y'all, but I have enough. So yes, I have a lot of tattoos on my leg. Oh, I have a tramp stamp too. I have a lot of tattoos.
She had a lot. No specific number. She has.
If you have any advice for the youth coming up, what would it be?
My advice for the youth coming up is stay in school. Get that education. Don't give up on your dreams. If you're going through something, don't keep it in. Tell somebody. Talk to somebody. There are people who will help you get through whatever you're going through. Keep the faith, because this world, and I'm saying this for all young people, but now my statement now is for all you Black young people. This world is hard on us, and do not let nobody tell you you can't do what you want to do, no matter what the situation is, no matter how bad the situation is. Can overcome anything. So that is my advice to the young people.
And if church say them. Amen.
My advice would be to be true to yourself, stay true to yourself, be honest with yourself. Stop trying to, you know, be with the in crowd or whatever. Always think outside of the box. Like, do what you want to do, not what your friends want you to do. If you feel like something they're doing is wrong, don't do it. Like, if they smoke and you just feel like smoking is bad, then don't do it. And don't allow people to pressure you into doing things. Follow your heart and follow what you feel is right. Because a lot of these people will lead y'all into some trouble. And trouble is easy to get in, but it's hard to get out. Mm-hmm. So just stay true to you. And listen to your parents. Let the church say amen again.
Amen. Amen. What is your favorite ice cream?
That's easy. My favorite ice cream is cookies and cream.
Oh, I knew you were about to say that. What then my favorite ice cream is?
Saki Bowl.
Look at her. Yes, I love me some chocolate.
What is your greatest fear?
Ooh. you know what's what I thought of, the movie I thought of when I heard this question. You wanna know what movie I thought of? Aquila and Me. My greatest fear is to leave this world in my real love. I think, not saying I've never been in love. I have been in love. But I haven't been in love, no real love. Like, I've never been in love. I've been in lust, I thought was love. So I would hate to leave this world and not know what real love is. Somebody I can argue with but still want to be around. Somebody I don't like being around folks. I get irritated way too quickly. So that is my biggest fear. Leaving this world not knowing real love.
I would say my greatest fear would be leaving this earth and not fulfill my true purpose. Like, I feel like I know what my purpose is, and I feel like I'm already in the direction of it, but I feel like because every God is coming, he's near, and it's like, Lord, I do not want to go up just yet, because I feel like I have not really fulfilled what I'm truly like, that really, really, really big giant thing I'm supposed to do. That's like supposed to make an impact on the world, not just locally, but like the nations. Like, it's all something that we're supposed to do that's supposed to like really touch many. And I feel like I haven't got there yet, and I don't want the Lord to come and snatch me up and be like, "Why didn't you?" Like, Lord, I was trying, but
That's my greatest fear.
Why are you crushing on?
I'm crushing on somebody that doesn't even know I exist.
Me too.
I'm actually crushing on two people that don't know I exist. One will never know I exist. One knows of my existence, but doesn't know me. Like,
no.
Are you going to say
that? I know who they are. My first one is a celebrity, and his name is Mario. Oh, Jesus. That man.
You see, she wants him.
He live in that name in B-more, so I was trying to catch him around here one day. I bet not ever get famous. I'm going to look for him. Anyways, another person that I crush on, his name is Kid Tory.
This is the one that knows of her existence, but doesn't really know her.
Like, we done had a conversation, like a small conversation, but, and I've supported him and his friends at their meet and greets. So he
UNDTV
knows a little bit of my existence, but he doesn't know me. And I'm pretty, it's a lot of females that crush on him, but, you know, he's a crush. That's just the answer. So, I just been able to become a celebrity because Mario, I'm coming for you. You're like, where is Mario?
That was too good one. Centauri is very handsome.
And he's a great person. And that's what makes him attractive. Because he's a rare breed.
The whole group is some very rare breed of men. I've considered them kings. They are some kings. And he stands out. He's like the innocent one. You know, I consider myself like innocent. I feel like he's the innocent one out the group. So I guess that's why I like go towards him more.
I can see that. He's very. The first one is an celebrity. And that is August Alsina. I have been in love with that man since he came out.
If it wasn't for her, it would be a lot of songs I did not know we even did, because when I met her, that's all she listened to.
I love August.
Woo!
That man does something to me. His music does something to me. But yes, August Alsina, that is my celebrity crush. My other crush is...
I already feel like I know who this one is.
My other crush is Alan Love.
He's actually part of the group of the guy I was just talking about.
He's a thug of the group. No, he's playing. Remember, she liked them bags. She liked them teddy bears that get a little rough.
He is very handsome to me. And I love that he can do rap and singing. That is a whole turn on. No, but he's very handsome. In person, just I feel like videos don't show all your features. But in person, that man is handsome,
tall and skinny.
Ooh, y'all know I love him tall. Now he ain't dark skinned, he brown skinned. But yes, Lord. Alan, you can get it.
What is something you can't live without?
This is really not a something, because I know a lot of people always say their phones. I can live without my phone. I know, you know, social media is a big thing right now, but I can live without my phone. This is really more of someone I can't live without, and that is my mother. I don't know what I would do when God brings her home. Like, that is going to be, I'm going to have to be strong for my brother because he's the mama's boy. But I am going to break. Like, that is going to be the worst day of my life. And I've had some worse days, but that is going to,
I can't live without my mama.
I can't say that even when I get older in a certain age, I'm still not going to be able to, I'm still going to take it as hard as I would now. I can't live without that lady. She is my backbone.
Well, mine is a someone too, and it's a group. It's my family. And you. Becoming an adult, like an adult, like I feel like as a teenager, like we're so nonchalant about the people in our lives and the things in our lives that we just don't realize the importance of the things that we have grasped of. So it's like now that I'm older, I really cannot, like, I hate being away from my family. Like this past weekend, they went out to dinner without me, and I my mama don't know this, but I was in my feelings. You watched this video, and I was mad at you, and we was about to fight.
Oh.
But, you know, I feel like the people connect with, I feel like I can't live without them. And I don't care how much, like, people be like, oh, I don't need nobody. Yes, you do. You need somebody. Do. So I feel like that is, those are those someones that I can't live without. Something I feel like I can't live without is water. Can't live without water.
Something I can't live without. Yeah, because I got a shower.
You need to stay hydrated.
True. That's true. That was a good one. What is your biggest pet peeve?
My biggest pet peeve, like, it's the biggest. Ooh, that's great. I do not like when people tell me they're going to do something and don't do it.
Mm.
Like, if you tell me you're going to do something, you have made yourself accountable for that. I'm a woman of my word. If I'm going to do something, if I tell you I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it. And if I'm not able to, I'm going to tell you, but eventually it's still going to get done. Like, it may not get done that day, but it's going to get done. Either way, we're going to communicate. I can't stand when people just don't do what they're supposed to do and then don't own up to. That's one of my biggest pet peeves. Like, if I give you $1,000 and I tell you this needs to get somewhere for something, and I found out that it didn't get there,
I have a whole problem.
I might just shoot you. Mm-hmm. Not just playing, I'm gonna do that. But I'm gonna look at you different, like you're not a responsible person and you're not trustworthy. And I'm gonna take it as is. You show me who you are and I'm gonna run with you. Okay? Oh. Alright.
Yes. And it's so crazy because I have a lot of pet peeves, but my biggest is people not using their goddamn blinkers. When you get older, use your blinker, because I fly. I ain't even going to let, I be driving.
I can agree with that.
When I say driving, I mean I be driving. And you telling me I got to slam on my brake? Skrrt! Because you're stupid. I do cuss a lot, y'all. I'm trying not to cuss. You didn't got over without no blinker. So, and now, I'm irritated at this point. And then when I go around you, you mad because I'm flipping you off. You almost just caused a whole accident. Made me try almost mess up my baby. Because my car is the love of my life right now. Because you want to be stupid, and I put on the blinker. Stupid! So, for all you folks that stay in Georgia, I don't care what part of Georgia you stay in, use your mother effing blinker. Or people like me is going to continue to roll past you, cuss you out, and flip you off. There you go. That's my biggest pet peeve.
Me, I like to stay. So... I'm gonna pull over to
in this world, what would you change?
The president of the United States of America. That's what I would change.
Barack, we want you back.
Let me tell y'all something. If murder wasn't a sin, I would have been shot here.
I had somebody say, like, look, I take the hit for all of us as long as y'all keep money on my books. I'm down for that. No, let me stop.
And I say, I would be his wife just for marrying him. Because, I pay attention to stuff, little stuff. Now, you see when Barack was in office, you see this man, he's such a gentleman. When it rained, he held the umbrella for Michelle. This man, this orange man with the toupee, he hold the umbrella for himself while his wife is getting wet. So his toupee won't get wet. What? Who raised you? He's not.
That is what I would change about this world right now. He is making so much things worse. He is causing chaos where there doesn't need to be chaos. This wild situation is going to get on my nerves. If somebody bring up this wild to me one more time, I'm going to cuss them out. Because I'm tired of it. Let the Mexicans come over here. We like them.
Is that wild? Me some amigos. Amigos.
Shoot. We love them.
They're some sweet people.
And they be working.
If it weren't for them, we wouldn't have a lot of these buildings up.
Exactly.
These parks. All over the world.
What y'all gonna do? It's when they just say, forget it, we all going back to Mexico. We gonna be out of luck.
What if they go decide to build their own wall? Y'all
and say, you can't come over here. Did you ever think about that?
You won't be able to drink tequila then, huh? Won't be sitting on margaritas then, huh?
Woo! But that's fine.
I would change, I would make tuition free. I'll make college tuition free. I feel like other than the fact that some people are just really careless with money, one of the biggest debts in this world is people who go to college and now they're in debt for going to college. Like, I would make education all across the board free.
Crazy thing is, I feel like college should be mandatory. Like, first kindergarten through 12th grade is mandatory. I feel like college should be mandatory where you don't have to pay for it. You have to go. Like, you have to get that degree. If you want to drop out, that's your... If you want to drop out after 12th grade, that's your decision. But I feel like college should be mandatory. It should be mandatory for those who want to go. You want to drop out, that's on you. You still pass the 12th grade, good for you. You can still get a decent job. But if you are... And if you have the grades and are willing to go make that sacrifice to give up 4 more years of your life, you should not have to pay for it. You should be able to go for your cost.
I feel like, okay, you should be like on a probationary period, right?
Yeah.
Like your first semester.
Your first year, fuck the semester. That semester go by fast.
Well, yeah, that's true. I feel like that should determine whether, okay, after this term, then you gotta pay. But I feel like if that term... You make the grades, it should be free after that.
Yeah.
And let's just say you just to keep going, you decide to, I'll make the grades this year, but I'm gonna kind of like
slack off.
Then that's when they probably see a letter, be like, okay, look, you was doing well, but now it seems like you're slacking. If you don't bring your grade up to this point,
you have to pay.
But I feel like off rip, we should not pay for education that's been repeated. When I went to school, I'm like, bruh, I didn't see this in high school. This is just high school senior. Like,
I've already done these courses in high school.
Yeah.
True. So it's like, I feel like, honestly, the biggest lesson is experience. Half the stuff we learn in college, you don't use it in your life, period. Like, your biggest life lesson is life. Like, an experience. Like, you're not going to use majority of the stuff that you're paying for.
True.
So I feel like they should probably put us on, like, a probationary period and be like, you got up to this point. And if you have to keep this GPA, these grades, and all these classes. And if you can't keep that up, then we don't ask for you to pay. But yeah, that's my answer.
What is your belief on relationships?
Need you to elaborate.
What do you feel like a relationship is? Or no. Let's change this question. It's going to be like a three-part question for the last question. What do you think is the steps in a relationship? What's dating, talking, being together? Like, what is the steps to you thinking somebody getting together?
I feel like the first step would be, dating. Because in the dating phase, you're actually getting to know the person. Like, you two are coming out of your comfort zones. Mm-hmm. And you're getting to know, like, yeah, this is my full name. This is how old I am. This is where I'm from, blah, blah, blah. This is what I like to do, or whatever. And then once you two get pretty much acquainted with each other through time, mm-hmm. then you get into the talking stage, which is pretty much like you both decide, like, okay, I like what I see, I like what I feel when I'm around you, and, you know, I don't want to really talk to nobody else. I made the decision that, you know, I just want it to be a us thing, just me and you, and then from there, after the talking stage, when you pretty much make things semi-exclusive, that's when you get into the relationship stage. And that's when you both decide, you cheat on me, I kill you.
Yes.
And from there, it's marriage. And it's happily ever after.
That's true. I do think... yes, you do start off by dating, because I feel like if I'm dating you, I can date multiple other people and get to know them as well. That is my definition of dating, because I know a lot of people get that mixed up. Dating and talking is the same thing. No, dating is you've been able to talk to that person and multiple other people and getting to know multiple people at the same time. Now, if I'm talking to you, that means I'm talking to only you. I am giving you my time and energy, so don't mess up, because I'm gonna be mad. And then relationship, I feel like once you get into that relationship, you're done for. You nobody else's. You are mine's.
Me and you are never going to team.
So that's how I feel about how that still works. Dating, talking, relationship. Get together. All right.
So, this concludes part one.
questions. This Creole.
Part two will be on her channel.
So come, subscribe, like, and comment.
Do your thing, do it.
Subscribe, like, and comment.
And make sure you subscribe. And we watch the video all the way through. Come say hey. Tell us what you think.
Give us your answers to the questions that we asked each other. We want to know what you think about those questions, your opinions, down in the comments below. Below. But, you know, you already know me, yeah. You already know I love y'all, you know. Wakanda forever. You know, our time is coming, you know. This is, I think this is the month of the Avengers, you know? Mm-hmm. Or is it next month?
Next month.
Okay, well, it doesn't matter. It's close. Our time is coming. We shall be risen. But anyways, I love you guys. And, you know, you're somebody. And you will do great things. We're going to continue to be great together. Okay. Anything for the people.
Mm-mm.
And we out of here.